ओमज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरोन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लांघायते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारिणं। कृपया क्षमतामपराधिजनं खलुषायुतशक्तसुदीननरं सुपथे परिचालय सर्वदिनं प्रणमामि च माधव देवपदं। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः। पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं। सप्तकांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। भुजे सव्य वेणुं शिरसि शिखिपिच्छं कटितटे दुकूलां नेत्रान्ते सहचर कटाक्षं विदधते। सदा श्रीमद्वृंदावन वसति लीला परिचयो जगन्नाथ स्वामी नयन पथगामी भवतु मे। वंदे नंद व्रजस्त्रीणां पादरेणुं अभीक्ष्णशः याशां हरिकथोद्गीतं पुनाति भुवनत्रयम्। भक्त्या विहीन अपराध लक्षै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादि तरंग मध्ये कृपामयी त्वां शरणं प्रपन्न वृंदे। नमस्ते चरणारविंदं भूमोस्खलित पादानां भूमिरेव यवलंबनं। त्वय्यजात अपराधानां त्वमैव शरणं प्रभो। वागीशा यस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्या च वक्ष्यासि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित्तं नृसिंहामहं भजे। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। So we are meeting after 2-3 days. Past 3 days we were busy with Param Gurudev's the shifting of the deity from his Samadhi temple to his Bhajan Kutir. So we couldn't find time to engage in other activities other than that. So yesterday Param Gurudev took his seat in his Bhajan Kutir. So his Seva Puja is going on in his Bhajan Kutir. So I hope we will continue our Bhagavat readings, recitations as we have been doing. So we will continue to, I hope to continue from today again. So the last we read was 4th canto, 11th chapter. We completed chapter number 11 when we read last maybe 3 days ago. wherein Manu is has advised Dhruva. Dhruva was killing so many yakshas because his brother was killed by them. So Dhruva was completely enraged and he was killing them. Then Manu, his grandfather, he came in front of him and then he advised that you are a devotee and everyone in the world respect you. Even God has, you know, sings about your glories. And after attaining such a respectful position, you are behaving like, you know, so, you know, without any humanity, without any mercy. This is not at all befitting you. Therefore, you should give up your anger. Like you have already performed Hari Bhajan, you pleased Hari, it is not very difficult for you. Hari is already pleased with you. That he who is very difficultly achieved by other persons, you have achieved him so easily. Therefore, it's not new to you or very difficult to you. Therefore, you should stop this, mercilessness, and then you should accept the service of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. In this way, he advised Manu. So now, today we will continue from we will begin chapter number 12 from today onwards. Shri Maitreya Uvacha, Dhruvam Nivrittam Pratibuddhya Vaishasada Peta Manyum Bhagavan Dhaneshwaraha Tatragatas Charana Yaksha Kinnaraihi Sambhuyamano Nyabadat Kritanjalim. Shri Maitreya Kahilen, He Vidur, Dhruvo Pitamaher Bakke Krodha Parityag Kuriya Hinsa Karja Hoite Nibritta Hoya Chen Iha Abhagat Hoya Dhanapati Kuber Tahar Nikato Upasthit Hoilen. So when Maitreya is speaking to Vidura, my dear Vidur, Dhruva, after he was advised by his grandfather Manu, he has given up his anger and his enviousness towards the Yakshas, because Yakshas have killed his brother, and because of his bodily affection towards his brother, he attacked the Yakshas. But upon the advice of his father Manu, grandfather Manu, he has given up his enviousness and his, you know, hatred towards the Yakshas, and by knowing this, Kubera, he was extremely pleased. Kubera is the king of the Yakshas. He is the proprietor of all the wealth. So Kubera, he became very much pleased with Dhruva as soon as he has given up the anger. Karan Jakha O Kinnara Gan Stav Korite Korite Tahar Paschat Paschat Agaman Korilo. And the Karanas, the Yakshas, the Kinnaras, all these persons also followed Kubera while they praised the glories of Dhruva. Because they all know that Dhruva is a very great devotee. Everyone in the world, they knew that, because within 6 months he has attained Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. Because we heard that when in the sixth month, when Dhruva has stopped inhaling even air, then the entire universe was suffocated. Nobody could, you know, accept air properly, because, you know, he had stopped the entire air through it. Means as soon as he stopped taking air, everything got stopped. So in this manner, you know, he has performed very, very intense penance. And then when Brahma and other demigods went to Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, that we don't know why, you know, we are suffocating, like a thing like this has never happened before. So some demon or some enemy is coming and attacking us probably, please save us. Then the Lord told, you don't need to worry, it is my devotee Dhruva who is performing severe penances, and because of that you are feeling suffocated. Don't worry, as soon as I go, I will relieve you from this, you know, suffocation. So in this manner, the entire world, everyone knows about the glories of Dhruva. So when Kubera came, Karanas, Yakshas and Kinnaras, all of them followed. Kubero Dhruvake Kritanjali Pute Dandayaman Dekhiya Tahake Sambodhan Purvak Kahite Lagile. And Dhruva was standing with his folded palms. He was, you know, offering respects to Kubera. And when Kubera saw that Dhruva was standing with his folded palms in a very respectful manner, he spoke to Dhruva in this manner. Shri Krishna Chakravarti Thakur writes in the commentary, Ehi dvadasha adhyaye Kubera hoite varaprapta hoya Dhruva nijapurite pratyavartan purvak बहुविध यज्ञेर द्वारा श्री हरिर आराधना करतः वैराग्यवशतः स शरीरे श्री हरिर धामे गमन करेन इहा वर्णित होइया छे. सो श्री कृष्ण चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर गिव्स अ वेरी वेरी ब्रीफ समरी ऑफ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी यू नो सेड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर. सो इन दिस 12th चैप्टर वी विल हियर दैट ध्रुव वाज given benediction by Kubera, means after Dhruva sings the glories of Kubera, Kubera becomes pacified and then he gives blessings, his a boon to him, and then Dhruva comes back to his own kingdom. He performs various types of worship and penances for Supreme Lord Sri Hari, and then Supreme Lord Hari is pleased, and ultimately Dhruva enters into the abode of Supreme Lord Sri Krishna with his own body. Means for others, they leave the body here. Before they leave this material world, they have to leave the material body here and they go back to Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. But Dhruva has entered into Supreme Lord's abode with his own body, without having to leave the body. So this is a very, very special benediction that Dhruva has got. So he got purified completely by performing various types of penances and worships for the pleasure of Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, and then ultimately he attained the abode of Supreme Lord. So this is what is being said in this chapter, and most likely this is the last chapter we are going to read about Dhruva's narration. So in the next subsequent chapters, Dhruva's children, grandchildren, his Dhruva's family lineage will begin. So with this chapter, we will conclude the Dhruva's life narration, and then we'll go to the next narration, probably the narration about Vritasura's life, his teachings, and his everything about Vritasura. We will start after this particular narration of this particular chapter is over. Shri Dhanad Uvacha. Ye thoda khol dena, dikhai nahi de raha. Okay. Bho bhoh kshatriya dayad परितुष्ट अस्मिन् ते अमघ यत् त्वं पितामहादेशाद्वैरं दुस्त्यज मत्यजः. धनपति कहिलेन, हे क्षत्रिय नंदन, हे निष्पापद्रु, आमी तोमार प्रति अतिशय संतुष्ट होइयाछि, केनना तुमी पितामह मनुर उपदेश अनुसारे सुदुस्त्यज्य शत्रुता परित्याग करियाचो. सो द कुबेर हु इज द किंग ऑफ और हु इज द ट्रेजरर ऑफ ऑल द डेमी गॉड्स ही स्पोक, माय डियर सन ऑफ अ क्षत्रिय. हियर ही एड्रेस्ड एज सन ऑफ अ क्षत्रिय, और सन ऑफ अ क्षत्रिय मीन्स द वैरियर क्लास, द फाइटिंग क्लास. सो माय डियर क्षत्रिय सन, हे ध्रुव, हु इज अनटच्ड बाय सिन. ध्रुव इज नॉट टच्ड बाय सिन, ही इज एड्रेसिंग हिम लाइक दिस. आमी तुमार प्रति अतिशय संतुष्ट होइया छे, I am extremely pleased with you. Kubera is telling, just because Dhruva has given up his war against the Kshatriyas, he became very pleased. He told that I am very much pleased with you, I am very much satisfied with you. Why? Kanona, because by listening to the words of your grandfather, you have given up your anger, given up your enmity towards the Yakshas who have killed your brother. You have given up your anger against them, which is very, very difficult. Why? Because you already addressed him as Kshatriya Nandan, son of a Kshatriya. Son of a warrior means for him it is very, very difficult to give up his enmity. Particularly, he has picked up, you know, enmity on a particular person, he cannot give up so easily. But he is very pleased because by following the order of his grandfather, he has done it. That is why, the truth of the fact is, if we obey the orders of the superiors, then everyone else is automatically pleased. To please everybody else, one has to obey the orders of the superiors. Guru Maharaj used to say, always respect superiors, always respect your elders. If you respect your superiors and elders, automatically everyone else will be satisfied, everyone else will be pleased. Here, simply because Dhruva has, you know, accepted the words or instructions of his grandfather and given up the fight and enmity, Kubera became extremely pleased. Na bhavan avadhid yakshan na yaksha bhrataram tava kala evahi bhutanam prabhurapyaya bhavayo. Tumi yakshagan ke binasht koronai. So here he is telling that actually you are not the killer of the yakshas. You have not destroyed the yakshas. Yakshaganu tomar bhrata ke binasht koronai. And also the yakshas, they have not killed your brother. You have not killed the yakshas, and the yakshas also have not killed your brother. Kalui praniganer janma mrityur ekmatra karan. It is actually time which is the actual cause of birth and death of various living entities. So, nobody else is the cause except time. Time, as we heard before, some call time as karma. According to our own time or according to our own karma, we take birth, we get various kinds of troubles or happiness, and then ultimately we die. All these things are happening by the influence of time. Nobody is to be blamed. Others can only be instrumental. A person who is intelligent, he will not worry about it. Ashochyan anva shochastvam pragyavadamscha bhashase gatasun agatasunscha na anashochanti pandita. A person who is actually learned, not others. Not those who think that they are learned, those who have so much knowledge about scriptures, he can quote so many scriptures, he can quote so many verses, not that person. Who is actually learned, that person never laments for those who are gone or those who are anyway going to be gone. He will not be worried about them, because those who have taken birth will ultimately have to die. There is, you know, no escape from that. Those who have taken birth will die. So that is why he is telling that it is actually not, you are not the cause of the destruction of the yakshas, and yakshas are not the cause of your brother's death. But it is only time that has influenced this.
Aham tamityapartha dhiragyanat purushasya hi स्वप्नि वाभात्य तद्ध्यानात् यया बंध विपर्ययौ पुरुषेर अज्ञानता वशतः स्वप्नकालीन ज्ञानेर नाय अमी तुमी यही रूप मिथ्या बुद्धि होया था के वही बुद्धि द्वारा देह अभिमान हुआ ते बंध और दुख उपस्थित फाय। सो एक्चुअली अ लिविंग एंटिटी ड्यू टू हिज ओन इग्नोरेंस ही थिंक्स इग्नोरेंस टू बी नॉलेज जस्ट लाइक इन अ ड्रीम ही सीज समथिंग एंड ही थिंक्स दैट द ड्रीम टू बी ट्रू। इन अ सिमिलर वे a living entity due to his own ignorance everything that is like a dream he takes it to be reality actuality and then he thinks that this is mine and this is his and a person becomes egocentric I-centric and therefore he fights against others or he harms others therefore he is telling that this is only due to one's own ignorance that you know, like in a dreaming state. But only through this particular dreamlike knowledge means that knowledge which does not have any strong base or foundation. In dream, we get anything, we see anything. It has no value. We value it on as long as we are only seeing it. We are in the dream. In the dreaming state, we evaluate, we think it to be factual. But it is not. It has no base, it has no foundation. Suddenly you are, you know, here and then the next moment in your dream, you are in America or you are in Indonesia or you are in Japan somewhere. Suddenly you find elsewhere. You are talking to your parents and suddenly, you know, some person who is not known to any one of you comes there. You know, all these things, these are all some creative, imaginary. They are not actual. That is why Brahmaji says swapnabham astadishanam puru dukkha dukkham. This world is entirely like a dream. Whether it is a day or night, we are dreaming constantly. So, a person who is in that dreaming state, artificially he thinks I and mine. Actually nothing is mine. Because when I took birth, nothing belonged to me. When I die, after I die, nothing belongs to me. In between, I have probably gained some money or I might have purchased a property or I might have got some name and fame. And I think that this money belongs to me, this house belongs to me, this property belongs to me, this wife belongs to me. Wife, he gets married after 25-30 years. Till 25-30 years, he does not have any association with that girl. Suddenly he comes in contact with a girl, he gets married, and then now, oh, this is mine. And then after he is gone or she is gone, there is no relation again. Children come after some time, and children, oh, these are my children. Because these were all not there when you came, you were alone. And when you go, none of these things accompany you also. Your wife does not accompany you, your property does not accompany you, your wealth does not accompany you, your children does not accompany you. Whatever that accompanies you is your own karma. The karma, whatever activities we are doing or the impressions that we are making in this life are going to be carried in the next birth. But the thing is that rather than trying to concentrate on those things that go along with us, we are trying to concentrate on those things that are going to be left anyway here. Wife will not go with me, children will not go with me, money will not go with me, property will not go with me. But I am endeavoring hard, day and night for these things. But whatever goes with me, my own activities, whether good or bad, those things accompany me. Devotion, performance of devotion, that accompanies me. I am not concentrating in that particular, you know, perspective, in that particular, you know, direction. So, this is only a waste of time. That which will accompany me, I am, you know, neglecting, and that I need to neglect, I am holding them. So, that is why here he is telling that this is like a dream, this is an ignorance, and out of this only one gets conditioned and one gets distress also. Because of thinking, because of our, you know, because we think that we belong to this material world, our conditioning. As long as the moment we think that we belong to Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, we shall be completely removed from all the kinds of bondages. The very problem that we are facing in this material world, the very reason for we are being bonded in this material world is nothing but I am thinking that I belong to this world. That is the reason. The moment I think that I am of Supreme Lord, immediately we are relieved from all any kinds of bondage, all kinds of bondages. And immediately we will feel blissful. But the thing is, it is very, very difficult. We don't want to do it. I don't want to give up my ego. I don't want to give up my property. I don't want to give up my wealth. I don't want to give up my wife. I don't want to give up my children. I want to hang on to all these things. I belong to this world. I am wife of such and such. I am husband of such and such. I am father of such and such. I am son of such and such. I am brother of such and such. Then there will be bondage, for sure. Then there will be unhappiness or distress, for sure. And those who have taken shelter of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna unlimitedly, they are free from all kinds of bondage and they are experiencing unlimited bliss. That is why Manu is telling to Dhruva that only it's actually time which is influencing one's birth and death. But just like a dream, those who are in the state of ignorance, they think that I and mine, yours and you are different, I am different. And in this manner, because of this kind of a conception, he is in bondage and he is in suffering. Shri Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur writes in the commentary, Atma vyati vyatirikta dehe atmatva rupe je anusandhan avadharana tahai tahar nimittai bandha. Arthat sansara punah punah sharira grahan. So here we are looking for our own self in that thing which we are actually not. Means we are thinking that we are the body. Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur is telling that we are Atma, but actually we are thinking that we are this body. What we are not, we are thinking that to be us. That is the problem with all of us. So that is why our conditioning. Why? Because I am thinking this, I am body, and therefore all my activities are concentrated around the body only. And for that reason, I have to take birth repeatedly, again and again I take birth, again and again I experience death also. But the moment I understand that I am Atma, I don't belong to this world, I belong to Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. That I am Brahma Bhuta, that I am coming from that Supreme Brahman, from the Supreme Lord, that is Prasannatma, he is constantly in bliss. Na shachati na kangshati. He has no mourning, no lamentation. Na kangshati, he has no desires. He is not desire, he has no desires because he understands that I belong to Paramatma, therefore I have Paramatma as my only object of worship. Therefore, he is in bliss always. He does not mourn for those who are gone or those who are anyway going to be gone. Even if we try to protect a person, I may think that I have money, I may think that I have very nice medical facilities available around me, and I have lots of wealth that I can spend. Simply having money, doctors and hospitals, one cannot save life. One can be saved only if the Lord wishes so. Mare Krishna rakhe ke, rakhe Krishna mare ke. If the Lord wants to kill someone, he does not want to kill per se. If the Lord, someone has to die, nobody can stop. And if someone is to be saved, nobody can harm him. because it is all entirely controlled by Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. The fruits are completely in the hands of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. Therefore, those persons who are wise, they don't worry, they don't mourn for, you know, that which is going to be lost anyway. They don't endeavor for this. They endeavor for that which is going to last forever. Everlasting thing, that is Atma. They will endeavor for Paramatma, not for body. But those who are in ignorance, they are constantly running after their bodily needs. So here, that is why this material conditioning, and that is why repeated acceptance of various bodies. Evang seijanno gyanandamay gyanandamay jiber vaiparjayo arthat agyano o dukkhadi upasthit hoya thake. And simply because he is thinking that he is body, or rather he is trying to look his self in his own body, which is not, which is by nature ignorance. And for this reason, Krishna Chaitanya Thakur is telling that he will be in constant troubles only. Atma is Paramananda Tattva, is a blissful principle. Sharir, body, is Ajnana Tattva, is an ignorant entity. His body is ignorance. Atma is knowledge. If we think I am body, we are in ignorance only. And ignorance only brings suffering. Ignorance never brings happiness. Ignorance means what? It is complete darkness. It is only suffering. The moment we are placed in our own self, that is Atma, which is by nature Anandamay. Anandamay means blissful entity. Once we are placed in that, then we will automatically become happy. Tad gaccha dhruva bhadram te bhagavad bhagavas bhagavantam adokshajam sarva bhutatma bhavena sarva bhutatma vigraham bhajasva bhajaniyangri mabhavad abhavaya bhavachidam yuktam virahitam shaktya gunamayatma mayaya. Ataiva he dhruv ei sthan hoite prasthan evang sarvabhute paramatma bhav darshan kurya atindriya sarvabhuta antaryami sansara harshi bhagavaner padapadma labh kurivar junno tahar bhajana karo. Therefore, my dear dhruva, you immediately leave this place. This place where you are fighting against the yakshas, this has become a battlefield. You immediately leave this place and you worship Supreme Lord Shri Krishna with the only purpose to attain the lotus feet of him. You worship him to attain his lotus feet. That Supreme Lord, he is present as Paramatma in all the living entities. You see that Paramatma in everyone's heart, samas sarveshu bhuteshu. That person sees everyone equally. He does not see inferior, superior, bad, good, nothing. He sees samas sarveshu bhuteshu. All the living entities are same. Why? Because all of them are coming from Supreme Lord Shri Krishna and all of them are blissful entities. I am seeing body, that is why I see others also as body. But a person who is seeing himself as Atma, he sees everyone else as Atma only. Therefore, he does not see a lion or a tiger or a man or a woman or a child or an old man. He does not see any of these things. He only sees sama sarveshu bhuteshu. All the living entities are same. They are coming from the same source. They are entering into the same source and their existence is for the same source. That is why that Supreme Lord, who is the super soul of all the living entities, you take his darshan always. You worship him. And Atindriya, he is beyond the sensory knowledge. Nobody can understand Supreme Lord through one's own sensory knowledge. Means as long as one is in the bodily conception of life, he cannot understand Supreme Lord. One has to become, you know, Atmavit. One has to become about, one has to become knowledgeful about one's own self. That is why, my dear Dhruva, immediately leave this place. And you see Supreme Lord Sri Krishna in all the living entities, in the heart of all living entities. He is beyond all the sense organs, and he is Sarvabhut Antaryami, he is all pervading principle. And therefore, you worship him in order to attain his lotus feet. Tahar Padapadmai Jivir Ekmatra Bhajaniya Vastu O Sansara Nivartak. His lotus feet are the only shelter. And his lotus feet are the only source of deliverance from this material world. All of us should take shelter of Supreme Lord's lotus feet only. That is the only place of worship, or that is the only shelter. And he, that is the only process by which one can get delivered from this material world. Tini sarvabhuta antaranga shakti yukta kintu tahate त्रिगुणमयी बहिरंगा मायार अधिष्ठान नाय तिनी मायाधीश. He is existing with his antaranga shakti, with his own internal potency. Means Krishna's body, the Lord's body, is not made out of the three modes of material nature. His body is not comprised of the ignorance. Like this body, this material body is made of the three modes of material nature, made by the three modes of material nature with various material elements. So this is Sharira Avidya Jal. This body is a place of ignorance because it is made of inferior items. Bhumi Aponalo Vayu Kham. So these are the five inferior elements with which this body is made of. But Supreme Lord's body is not comprised of this, you know, material elements. He is comprised of, with his own internal potency. He is living with his own internal potency. And tahate trigunamayi bahiranga maya radhishtannai. There is no scope of this external maya's existence within him. Although this maya belongs to him, it does not reside in him. Means maya does not influence him, does not affect him. Maya belongs to him. It is his external potency, but it is not in touch with him, or he is not touched by maya. He is mayadhish. He is the controller. Means maya is inferior to him. Eirupa Shri Bhagavaner Aradhana Korilei Tomar Mangal Hoibe. Only if you worship Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, You will get eternal benefit. You will get eternal welfare, because he is beyond all these, you know, material conceptions. He is beyond maya. Therefore, if you want to cross over maya, if you want to get actual deliverance, if you want to be freed from all your ignorance, from your ignorance, then you should worship Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, and to get ulterior benefit. Sakala pranite. Oh. Time is up. Is there to baja nahi? Okay, so we will continue the purport tomorrow. Vancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindubhya evacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namo. Jai Granthara Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran ki jai. Sri Krishna Dvaipayana Vedavyasa Mahamuni ki jai. जय श्री श्री ध्रुव महाराज की जय. जय परमार्थम श्री गुरु महाराज की जय. गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल.